baby. Extra bright, I want y'all to see this. Turn up the lights in here, baby. You know what I need, want you to see everything. Want you to see all of the lights.
Make sure that you support Soul of Brooklyn, and I'm gonna let DJ Trauma take it out. You all can dance in the interim, you can rock in your seat, you can do the two-step, whatever you wanna do. And in the next 5 minutes, we're gonna get started with Rip the Runway and the most beautiful and fantastic models and fashion designers in Brooklyn, New York.
Thomas on the red carpet at the Soul of Brooklyn Fashion Show, and she is the designer of Live Again. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
I'm very well. You actually opened the show, so you were the first designer on. How did that feel?
Spectacular. I had a grand time. It was wonderful to come out and give Brooklyn a taste of my creation.
How would you describe your style that you designed for the women's wear line?
I would say it's classic, if you would say. It never goes out of style, so to speak. Our t-shirts, you know, hand-painted, the skirts hand-painted as well. Live Again, I've done like Bob Marley, Bruce Lee, just a lot of positive folks who have passed on, who've left positive messages. I just want to bring it back, I just give it a boost.
Covering the Soul of Brooklyn Fashion Show, and I'm speaking with one of the designers who just showed, Tasiya Sealey of Purple Pill Babies.
Yes, hi, how are you today?
So good, how are you feeling? You just debuted your collection.
I'm feeling good, it was my first show, so I'm like,
really?
It was, yes.
How long have you been designing for?
I've been designing for like 2 years.
And what made you pick the name Purple Pill Babies? That's really interesting.
Thank you. So Purple Pill Babies is paying homage to the movie The Matrix. So the blue pill, if you know what that means, the red pill, if you know what that means. And when you put it together, we're all Purple Pill Babies. You know, we want ignorance is bliss, but we want to know. We want infinite knowledge. And through my designs, you know, it's like pretty much that's what I'm doing. I'm mixing this pretty modern, you know, kind of un-African way of living with the traditional African element, so it's kind of like just really a mixture. I have a whole term for my whole collection, so it's called Eclectic African Chic.
Justice Belle, and you had the line with the jewelry.
Right. Justice Belle, the Rock Goddess Jewelry Collection. It's gold, metal, silver, pearls, and gemstones, and Swarovski crystals.
And it's beautiful. That sounds like exotic and like high quality.
It is. It is high quality. Uh-huh. It is definitely exotic. All the pieces are custom made, and I only do them in limited quality, so you won't see that many people with your pieces.
How long have you been doing the jewelry line?
I actually just started. This is my first launch, actually, this year. My mother makes jewelry. I've always been slightly obsessed with jewelry.
So the Rock Goddess collection that you just showed on the runway, what was your inspiration behind that?
beautiful stones. Like, I love all types of colors, rocks, and it was pretty much just an experimentation to see what I could do. You know, if I saw something I thought it was beautiful, I would just get it, you know.
Come again, 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 Major Lazer.
Anisah Ansari of Brown Skin Ladies, paying homage to all the beautiful brown skin women.
Of course, yes. Uh-huh.
Tell everybody where you're from.
Brooklyn. Born and raised strictly, yes.
I know the fashion show is a dedication to, like, African businesses and designers. Are you, your nationality, are you African?
I consider myself an African born in America, but I was born here. Yeah. So I am African, yes.
Tell everybody what, like, your collection was that you just showed, and describe, like, what your inspirations were and where you were going with it.
Well, I love colors and different prints, but I knew there needs to be a way to tie it all together. So I used the hood as a way to tie it all together. I like everything from pants. There's nothing in particular that I wanted to stick to. I love it all, so I showed it all. So, yeah.
What was, like, your favorite trend that you used this time around?
Pants, because I finally learned how to do it.
You just learned how to do pants?
Yeah, so I tried to put it in there. So it was fun to know how to do it and put it in the fashion show.
So you're a really new designer then?
Yeah. I crochet mostly before. So mm-hmm. I'm used to crochet designing, but now it's fabric, so I'm new to that. But
so how long has it been really for you?
4 years.
Okay.
4 years. Not that new, it's just different medium.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. But I was definitely excited about all the stuff you've seen. I want to put on, like, a little hood and just, like, walk down the street with this. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you.
Founder and the executive director of Soul of Brooklyn, Laurie Cumbo. Hi, Laurie.
How are you?
I love this.
Thank you. This was actually made by our director of education at Mocada. It's just talent everywhere.
There actually is talent everywhere, and you're so great for exposing this in Brooklyn and, like, bringing everyone outside. This beautiful summer day. Such a good show. What made you want to start doing this?
When I see beautiful women like you, I feel like we have to do something to celebrate that and to give it a platform. And I was so excited to bring together the fashion designers in Brooklyn, New York, bring them to Fort Greene and expose them, because our talent is just everywhere. There's so much creativity all throughout the borough of Brooklyn, and we need to create a platform for that so that we can celebrate it, and we can also create an economy around it as well too. So my main goal at the end of the day is for these businesses, fashion designers, clothing designers, graphic designers, DJs, musicians, restaurateurs, everybody, we should be making more money and bringing in more resources to the borough, because Brooklyn is hot right now. How can the businesses of the African diaspora, how can the cultural institutions benefit from this boom that's taking place?
That's amazing. You know, like, we don't get so much spotlight, especially on people, like, from on the ground, and that's exactly what DopeFiles does. So I'm so glad that we found you, and we found the Soul of Brooklyn.
This has been a part of a whole week. This event is one event that's part of Soul of Brooklyn Week, which is from June 18th through the 25th. And so it rained last week, so we were, like, on pins and needles. What are we going to do? But I was so happy that we were able to reschedule it for tonight. And the crowd and the turnout was amazing. It's a lot of young designers, fresh ideas, innovation that you don't normally get a chance to see. So I was really excited about that.
Absolutely. I had a good time. We saw some great stuff here on the runway. Laurie, you did a great job tonight. I just must say, just a woman in charge. Miss Obama. She's like a little Obama right here.